The following exercises are suitable for these prosthetic knee joints. Apart from that, always consider the user's physical condition. Franziska and Gerhard show a few simple but effective exercises to improve stance phase. A good stance phase is the basis for a secure gait. The load is shifted to the prosthetic side during the first exercise. The upper body stays upright. The trunk should not lean laterally and the pelvis should not drop laterally. Franziska shows how to increase the level of difficulty step by step. Security measures are reduced and later combined with arm movements. The following exercise is used for extending the length of stance phase while walking on level ground. The hip extensors are activated more intensively and the center of mass moves forward more dynamically. The prosthetic knee joint identifies this exercise as a step and allows stance release. Due to the knee extension moment caused by the ground reaction force, Gerhard, however, feels secure as he doesn't feel that the stance release has already been triggered. Only by a subsequent hip flexion movement would he initiate swing phase. The aim of the exercise is to keep the hip extensors activated and to stabilize the hip. During the second repetition, Franziska tells Gerhard to actively initiate swing phase by pulling the residual limb into flexion after the knee is extended. This is important for a deeper understanding of the functionality within the knee joint. If Gerhard has already placed the contralateral foot on the bench and then tries to bend the knee after a slight delay, he bends against the stance flexion resistance. As soon as Gerhard is able to activate the hip extensors, Franziska reduces the security measures. The following exercises force the user to shift the weight to the prosthetic side and train hip extensors and abductors. The center of mass is shifted to the prosthetic side. The upper body is upright. The board can be moved more easily if the prosthetic side is loaded sufficiently. Gerhard should carry out the movement as far as he is able to while stabilizing his hips and without tipping laterally. The hands are just for stability. To stabilize the abductors, the board will be rotated and moved sideways. Gerhard places the prosthesis near the inner edge of the balance board. This way, he has enough space to move. Even in this case, the hip stays stable without dropping. During correct movements, Gerhard feels the contraction of the lateral and posterior glutes. As an alternative to the balance board, a sheet of paper can be used for both exercises. The sheet lies on the ground and is shifted forward and backward by the contralateral leg. The following exercise works to strengthen the core muscles and to increase stability while standing. Both shoulders stay relaxed while the strap is pulled sideways using both hands. During this movement, the hip stays directly forward instead of rotating. Using a mirror, Gerhard is able to independently check the position of his shoulders and the movement of his hips. Now from the same starting position, side steps are carried out. Gerhard executes the exercise as far as he can keep the position of his arms and upper body. This requires great tension in the core muscles. The hip abductors are required at the same time. Good core muscles are essential for a safe and dynamic gait. It is also possible to move forward and backward against the tension of the strap. This exercise additionally trains slight yielding steps using the stance flexion resistance.